In this video, I'm going to be talking about how you can plan your marketing campaign. And if you're new to me, welcome. My name is Rudo Dube, and I help you get clients on a consistent basis in a profitable way. So I'm going to be talking about all the steps that you need to take in terms of you planning out your marketing campaign. So for you to have a successful campaign, all these steps needs to be done in your business. That way you'll be able to get the results that you're looking for from that campaign. So it doesn't matter what kind of campaign you're coming up with, right? You're planning to launch. It could be an email marketing campaign. It could be a social media campaign. It could be your Facebook ads campaign. Whatever marketing campaign you're planning to launch, you need to follow some of these steps that I'm going to be sharing with you. That way you have a successful campaign in the end. Because what I see most of the time when people are coming up with their campaigns, they focus on one aspect only. But you can't just focus on one aspect only without looking at the whole visual, the whole journey throughout the business. Right? Because if you're just going to be concentrating on one section, let's say your Facebook ads, right? And if you're going to be focusing, let's say you'll think that maybe if you were to just concentrate on targeting, that'll bring the results that you need in your whole campaigning. But forgetting other aspects of that marketing campaign, you're not going to get the results that you need because you're just focusing on one aspect of your whole marketing campaign instead of focusing on the whole marketing campaign planning, right? So that's what I'm going to be sharing with you, and hopefully you'll like these steps and useful in your business. And if you do find it useful, make sure you like this video, comment and share, and subscribe, and turn on that notification button. That way you don't miss any other notifications. And if you do like this video and find it useful, I have a free training that I'm going to put a link down in the description that you can check out on how you can get clients on a consistent basis following some of the strategies that I'm going to be sharing with you in this video. So to start off with, when you're coming up with your marketing campaign, it's important for you to start thinking, what is the problem that you're solving? What is that problem that you're solving? When you're clear on what problem you're solving, you need to be now looking to who is your ideal client. What is that target market that you want to target with your whole marketing campaign, right? So you really need to understand who is your ideal client, really understand what are the pain, the frustration, and what are their goals, their desires, what they aspire to achieve, right? And really get to really know them, because it's really important when you get to know them, know what kind of languages they're using in terms of describing what they're going through, right? Their frustration, their problems, right? That way you'll be able to then come up with the offer that you're going to be presenting to your ideal client, to the target market that you want, right? So an offer is just simply that path that you're going to be leading them, that you're going to package into a product or service where you take someone from point A, where they have their frustration, their problems, to point B, where they get to their desired state where they want to get to in terms of their goals, their desires, and their aspiration. So that package, you have to make sure that that offer is irresistible so that they know that you are the one who has the answers to them, who has the solution to get them from point A to point B, and package it up, adding some bonuses or whatever, right? In terms of making it more irresistible for them, that way they don't see any other option to say, yes, this is what I've been waiting for. So once you have your offer packaged and ready for them, the next thing that you need to consider in terms of your planning your marketing campaign is to now come up with a messaging. So the messaging that you're gonna come up with, it comes down from understanding who your ideal client, right? So your messenger has to resonate to them, he has to speak to their pain points, painting that possibility of them getting to where they want to get to in terms of point B, right? To their goals, their desires, and aspirations. So your messaging needs to be congruent, it has to be consistent throughout your whole marketing campaign, throughout your whole landing pages, your ads, your funnels, right? So you really need to come up with that message that way you can present to them. You have to speak their language, right? Because if you're clear of who your ideal client are, you know the language they're using. That way you can speak to them and they get to see that you really understand what they're going through, you really understand their frustration. That way they'll be like, hey, you're speaking my language, you know where I am right now, and I trust and believe that you'll be able to take me to that point B that I want to get to, because you have made it clear to them through your messaging throughout the whole marketing campaign that you understand your ideal client, you know where they are, and you can get them to where they desire to reach. So once you have your message, now you can set up the funnel. And the funnel is just a simple process of where you're going to take someone through getting aware that you exist, to the process where they get interested in what you have to offer, desire what you have to offer, all the way down to becoming a client at the end. So it can be a series of pages, take them through, right? So funneling them down to through the whole process in your business, right? That way they end up being a client at the end. So when you walk them through that funnel that you're going to set up, remember again, your message has to be congruent, has to be consistent throughout that process in your funnel. So that's the next part. You have to come up with your funnel, set it up so that you'll be able to take your customers or your ideal clients through that process, right, in your business, walking them through that customer journey, right? So really, I need to understand your customer journey from the point where they get to be aware of who you are, right, or the process where you build a relationship, nurturing them, all the way to the process where they become clients at the end. So that's the next part where you have to plan out your funnel, make sure that it's all congruent with your message and speaks to your ideal client, and you have that offer that you're going to offer at the end, and they become clients. So once you have your funnel ready, now you have to plan out what channel you're going to be using, what platform are you going to be using in terms of reaching to your ideal clients, right, or your target market. So is it Facebook, is it Instagram, is it YouTube, Google, right? So if you had already done that whole exercise with the ideal client, you know where your ideal client hang out on, right, and you know where their attention is, right, or who has their attention. So you need to think of what kind of channel are you going to be then going there to present your offer through, right, or where you're going to be targeting your ideal clients on. So that's the next part. Think of the channel, the platform that you're going to be targeting your ideal clients on. So when you know the channel or the platform where your target market is, so now you have to come up with goals. What are the intentions of this marketing campaign, right? Is it to get more leads? Is it to get more sales? Is it to have a brand awareness? What is the specific goal for you to be running this whole marketing campaign? So you have to sit down and think of what is the goal for this. So remember, when you're coming up with the goals, they have to be SMART goals. So SMART, if you remember, it stands for S, has to be specific goal, right? So you have to set up what's the specific goal, like in terms of what exactly you're planning to achieve from running this marketing plan, right? Like as I said, is it for goal for leads? Is it for getting engagement? Is it to brand awareness? Is it to get sales, right? So what is the goal, ultimate goal of you running this marketing campaign? And then from there, so it has to be measurable, right? So you have to be able to check the metrics, right, in terms of the, or in terms of checking the key performance indicators, right? Like think of how you're going to measure the success of this campaign. And then the next one is attainable. Is the goal attainable? Are you able to achieve what you're planning to achieve in terms of your goal for this marketing campaign, right? And for R is for relevant. Is this relevant goal? Is it important goal for your business, right? Is it relevant? And T is the time frame. What is the time frame? How long are you planning to run this marketing campaign, right? Are you going to be doing it for 2 weeks, 3 weeks, 4 months, whatever time frame, right? So you have to decide how long are you planning to run this marketing campaign. So you have to have a time frame for that. So once you have set up your goals, your SMART goals of this whole purpose of running this campaign, the next part is to come up with your budget. So what's going to be your budget for this whole marketing campaign? So what's your daily budget? What's your weekly budget? What's your monthly budget? Depending how long you're planning to run your marketing campaign, right? So you really need to be clear on what's your budget, because you don't want to just go there willingly running your campaign without a specific budget that you're going to be spending for this whole marketing campaign. Once you have all these parts all planned out, the next part is to actually launch your ads. So you then have to launch your ads and start running your marketing campaign. So after launching your ads, you then have to keep checking your ads to make sure that they're running, as long as you know your numbers, right? So you need to know your numbers, you need to know your metrics, you need to know what are those key performing indicators to make sure that your ad is running and bringing the results that you're looking for, that you're planning to get in terms of your goals, right? So you need to make sure that you know your numbers, you know your metrics, you know your KPIs, and then you'll be able to optimize. So the last part is to optimize your whole marketing campaign, right? So you'll be using those metrics, those numbers, your numbers, right, that you are getting from running those ads, right, to make sure what's working, what's not working, and change it quick as you go. So looking at each part of that whole marketing process to say what's working. Is my ads working well? Is the funnel working well? Is my whole offer working well as well and getting me all the results that I want to get throughout the whole marketing campaign? So make sure you know your numbers, you're checking and optimizing as you go. So these are the key steps that you have to take in terms of coming up with your marketing campaign for your business. I hope you found this video useful and you liked it. Comment below with any tips or any other strategies that you have found useful in your business. And if you have any other topics that you'd like to learn or that you'd like us to share with you or teach you on, let us know in the comments. Now stay strong, stay positive, and continue building your dream business. And I'll see you next time. Take care.